And what's up, everyone, and welcome back to the Daily Pfav. This is episode 56 for Monday, May 21st, 2018. The time is now 11:21 p.m. Eastern Time, and today is the first full day, first full work day of National EMS Week. I had mentioned it yesterday that Sunday through this Saturday is EMS Week. Will be celebrated nationwide because in 1974, President Gerald Ford said so, and we've been doing it ever since. And so today, I had a good group of crew members on board today at the ambulance base, and I kind of grabbed all of them to do some pictures because all week long, I want to showcase all of my employees to the world. And very similar to how I did last year with Faces of EMS, I'm a big believer in the people that do this job, especially the people that choose to work for me. I have such a deep appreciation for all of them, and the only way I know how to honor them is through my photography and showcasing it to the world and putting it out there on social media. Just so happened last year that my Faces of EMS got picked up nationally and actually became the theme for EMS Week 2017, which was a great honor to have happen, not only for me and my photography, but all of EMS in Western Pennsylvania. It's something that I don't think will ever happen again because you kind of can't buy the theme for EMS Week. It has to be selected. And so I'm very grateful that the American College of Emergency Physicians, and the National Association of EMTs decided to use my work last year. That was fantastic. This year, it's a totally different theme. It's still under the banner and hashtag of EMS Strong. And again, it's showcasing people around the world in EMS. And so I'm going to, all week long, every day, a new set of crew members are going to come in, and every day I'm going to do some kind of photo shoot with them during their downtime and try to get these pictures out there. So again, if you follow me on all over social media, that's Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, you'll see the nice black and white shot I got of the four gentlemen that worked today. I think it's a cool shot. Kind of had a unique idea. It's a little bit of a different picture than I normally take. And I had the four of them just grab some equipment from the ambulance and walk across the parking lot while I was laying flat on my stomach in a restaurant parking lot, kind of shooting up towards them. Of course, I did it in black and white because for me, when I'm trying to tell a story, especially one with a lot of emotion, black and white is my go-to, and my black and white is much different than a lot of other black and white photography that's out there. Is you have to understand that black and white is just not black and white. There's literally probably 1,000 different ways to do black and white photography, and black and white still has color in it. And when you're editing black and white pictures, especially in Lightroom, you have to not forget to adjust all the different color sliders because each one of them impacts and affects your image in a different way. So I do my black and white much different than a lot of photographers do. That's just my style, and that's kind of what works for me and what makes me sit back and say, this is a final image. And then I export it and put it out there to the world for social media to enjoy. And so, again, if you're on social media, jump over and check that picture out. I'd appreciate it, especially this week, if you show my work as much love as you can with some likes and loves and retweets and thumbs ups and hearts and all that other jazz that's out there, because these people deserve it. Everyone that wears the uniform and answers the call and puts their health and well-being and safety and literally their life on the line every day to go help people, they're the ones that deserve that attention. And, you know, if you guys can play a role in that, I would greatly appreciate it. And wherever you live and wherever you're listening to, and welcome to Nepal, India, because I noticed today on my analytics that people are listening over there. So welcome and thank you. And again, to everybody in EMS around the world, enjoy your week of celebration. I know this is a week, and as much as I appreciate all of the hospitals locally and everything that they do for us during EMS week, my God, the amount of calories that we're going to intake this week are going to be through the roof, because every day is a picnic lunch somewhere. I know tomorrow one of the hospitals is bringing us breakfast at 7:30 in the morning to the station, and that's fantastic and that's great, but I got to find some time to try to burn some calories or go for a walk or do something, because every EMS week, I know how I feel at the end of EMS week, and it's not a fun feeling just from having eaten so much food. But again, I hope you guys enjoy the EMS week pictures, especially the one from today, and the rest of them that have yet to be created that I will be putting out each and every day through Saturday this week. And remember, wherever you live, when you see your local EMS, especially this week, don't be afraid to walk up to them and say thanks, or, you know, drive by the station and give a beep. They'll know what it means. Trust me, people have been driving by beeping all day today, and they will all week long. So again, this has been the Daily Pfav, episode 56. All of my shows available at paulfalavolitopodcast.com. 412-701-4323 for any comments, questions, or feedback you may have. As always, thank you so much for listening, and I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.